Hello everyone, my name is Nibus Lives and I'm your VTuber Senpai. 2D VTubing has been getting insanely popular, and sadly there isn't a lot of videos out there to show you how to import your model into applications like VTube Studio. But that is changing today, because today I'm going to show you on how to import your Live2d model into VTube Studio. But before we do that, if you happen to like today's video or the content I am producing on this channel, make sure you hit that like and subscribe button. By liking the video, you actually help it show up more in the algorithm, and by subscribing, you help the channel itself get more and more perks down the road. Also consider checking out my Twitch, my Twitter, and my Patreon, links for all those in the description and pinned comments down below. But enough about all that, let's just get into the video. Alright, let's open up Steam and go to VTube Studio. Now, here we are at Steam. All we need to do is just type in VTube Studio, and we see it actually auto-completes for us. Now, we're going to click on it, and we're going to download the free version of this software first. We're going to basically test the model, make sure it works the way it should. As soon as we do know that it does work, we can pay for the $17.49 to remove the watermark, but if you can't afford it, you can absolutely use the free version. Once that's done downloading and installing, all we need to do now is basically set up our avatar. Okay, so now that we have the application itself open, we're going to notice that there's nothing here on the left-hand side that appears. All you got to do to make that show up is just double-click anywhere in the window, and as you see, this now appears. So we got avatar import, take a picture, lock everything on the screen, and our settings. Let's first tackle importing our Live2d model into VTube Studio. All right, now we're going to click on this little icon on the top left-hand side that looks like a person. I'm going to bring up this. Now we have import, unload, and some default avatars that come with the software. What we're going to do is we're going to click on import your own model. It'll tell us where the path is, but handy enough, they give us an open folder. We're going to click that. Now that the folder actually opened, we see where all the models actually go. Now, if you're using typically a 3D avatar, you're going to know that it imports with a VRM file. But 2D actually imports with all these different little files right here. So what we're going to do is we're just going to keep all of our avatar stuff in the one folder. We're going to drag it and drop it into the Live2D. Close this, click OK here, close and reopen the software so it detects your model. Now this part is very crucial, because if you don't close and reopen the software, it will not detect no matter how long you wait. I also want to give a big shout out to Thorntail. You can check him out at twitch.tv/thorntailswamp. He was the one that provided us the 2D avatar for today's video, so make sure you go say hi, give a follow, and well, let's continue the video. Now that we have the software reopened, what we're going to do is we're going to click on this avatar icon again. We're going to see that the name of our avatar is located right here. We're just going to double click it. And then we see that it gives you some instructions on how to scale, rotate, and all that fun stuff. We're just going to click OK. This is an empty model. Do you want to run auto setup for model? Actually, I kind of do. So we're going to have it auto setup for iPhone/webcam. Click on that. It'll create 19 new VTS parameters. We're just going to click A-OK. And now this avatar is set up. So we're going to zoom in just a little bit. We're going to adjust a little bit. So zoom in with the scroll wheel. Move the avatar around with the hold and right click. And I think he's looking pretty good right there. But we aren't done yet. We got to set up the tracking. Now, before we go too far, I want to make sure that you know that you have to have your avatar rigged before you bring it into VTube Studio. The main reason for that is if your avatar is not rigged, these next steps probably won't work. So make sure your avatar is rigged before you proceed. To start the tracking on your avatar, what we got to do is, again, double click. We're going to bring up the little gear icon. We're going to click it. And we're going to click on this little webcam icon on the top left-hand side. Right here, we're going to see webcam tracking. We're going to choose our camera. Yours is probably going to be set to the wrong one, same as mine. That's okay, though. We're going to go to the appropriate webcam. Now, your webcam might be like a C920 or something different. That's okay. Just select your webcam and then hit select. It's going to ask you the resolution. I'm going to go with 1080 because that's what my camera can handle. We're going to hit select. I'm going to hit 60 frames per second because, again, that's what my camera can handle. The highest, the better. And I'm going to hit select. And then right here it says, please select a color format. Best for CPU performance, worst CPU performance. Click on whatever one you think is going to work for you. I'm going to click on YUY and then I'm going to hit select. Now, what we need to do is we need to turn on the camera. So let's click on the camera on and this little notification will come up. Basically asking you to purchase VTube Studio Webcam Tracking DLC. Now, if you do end up liking the software, please, please, please do so. Please purchase this software because these devs absolutely deserve this. And I'll explain to you a little bit later why. We're going to hit A-OK. And as we see right now, well, everything's kind of working. We see that I'm here. If we just hit the calibrate so it's centered. Perfect, perfect. It's, hey, I'm winking. Perfect. Now we see it's actually tracking as it should. Now let's take a look at some other settings like eye blink sensitivity, eye open sensitivity, all these little different settings you can play around with. And just like that, we're kind of set up. All right, so now let's take a look at some settings that we can play with to get this set up for OBS. But not only that, this program actually has a lot of cool little settings in it that I think we really should take a look at. All right, so let's get our avatar set up for OBS first. So what we're going to do right now is click on this little photo icon here. Just a one click. And we see there's a lot of different backgrounds they actually include that we can play with. But what we're going to do is we're going to go to color picker. Then we're going to hit select. Right now, it pops up with a prompt. Please note that VTube Studio supports streaming with transparent background on Windows, so you never have to use a chroma key or green screen in your capture software. To use this, activate the transparent in capture toggle, then create game capture in OBS with the option allow transparency activated. With this option, your model will look best in your capture. So we're actually going to do that. We're going to hit OK. And we're going to, well, it's already selected. Transparent in capture. This is perfect. This is what we want. Let's check out some very noteworthy settings. So let's bring up the gear icon again by double clicking. Click on the gear icon and we see here. Hide VTube Studio logo. When you disable that, you just see the logo on the bottom left-hand side. We're going to keep that enabled. One thing you do want to for sure enable is remember scene. What that does is basically anytime you open up the software, everything that you have selected before shows up again. Open data folder basically just brings up the avatar folder, connection settings, Wi-Fi. What this lets us do is actually use our phone as a webcam. They actually have this built in and they have an app that you could download on your iPhone or Android that allows you to connect all your stuff via Wi-Fi to this application. So if you don't own a webcam, your iPhone or your Android phone will actually work for this, and it's fantastic. We're going to scroll down a little bit more and we see USB settings. So again, connecting your phone via USB, that is definitely a doable thing. Mouse input config, don't really need to play with that. Microphone settings. So right now it is capturing my face and all my lip movement with just, well, the webcam. So if you want to use your microphone, just enable this. Select your microphone and you're good. Scroll down a little bit more. Nothing else really to see there. Click on the little webcam icon again and we see quality and effects, application FPS. We got it to VSync. You can change it to whatever you want. We also have a virtual webcam built in that actually works pretty well. I played with it a little bit. It is fantastic. So if you need a virtual webcam, AKA sending this feed out to Discord, Skype, whatever, you can just enable that. It'll give you a little installation instructions. Fantastic software. All right, we're going to click on this little gear icon up here. We see that's the model and we can actually model lock. So we can't change any of these settings, but again, auto blinking, auto breathing, inputs, different things you can play with. You know, when it's looking one way or looking another, this is just so many good options you can play with this software. So we got here the little film icon. Again, we got hotkeys here, use screen button hotkeys. Basically, this is stuff for recording if you need to do so, or if you want to send it out to your OBS stuff this is where you can play with it a little bit. Now that we've gone through all the settings, let's get this into OBS and fully set up. Now, I am going to assume that your OBS is set up and ready to go. If it is not, please check the note cards that are now appearing up above, where I guide you through setting up all your OBS settings. But what we're going to do right now is under sources, we're going to click on the little plus sign. Then we're going to go to Game Capture. Under Game Capture, we're just going to call it VTube, and then we're going to click OK. Then we're going to go to Mode. We're going to capture specific window. We're going to click on VTube Studio, and then we're going to make sure we click on Allow Transparency to remove the background, and then click OK. Then what we're going to do is we're going to move our avatar to position, so down, and right here is the watermark for VTube Studio. I really suggest that you buy the software if you do like it, because these creators and developers absolutely deserve every penny. In fact, I am going to buy their software because I do plan on getting a 2D model in the future, and I actually really want to support these guys. But right now, we could just move it to where we need it, or you can move it so it hides it, up to you, but adjust it to where you want it, and you can adjust it the size accordingly. Out of all the Live2d software I checked out so far, VTube Studio is absolutely one of the best ones out there. In fact, I actually think VTube Studio triumphs over a lot of 3D VTubing software because the amount of time and care they put into it, a lot of settings that I really think 3D VTubing software could use. So, 3D VTubing software creators, I'm calling you out. Check out VTube Studio, see what they're doing, and maybe yoink and twist your own version of it. Again, my name is Anubis Lives. I stream on Twitch every Monday, Wednesday, Friday evenings. Come on by, say hi. Let's talk about anime, gaming, VTubing, whatever. And well, I'll catch you in the next one. Bye.
Lizard Brothers. It's now time to take over the world.